What's a batch file? Hi everyone, Leo Notenboom here for askleo.com. Got the question. I've seen you mention a batch file a couple of times in articles. What is that and what's it good for? Batch files, or command files as they're often called also, are basically nothing more than text files that contain a series of instructions to be executed within a Windows command prompt. In other words, it's kind of a small computer program. Now, what I want to do is I'm going to show you a couple of simple examples to give you just sort of a sense for some of the kinds of things you can do with batch files. To do that, we'll switch over to Windows 11. What I'm going to start with is something very, very simple. We are going to Windows R, run, and you can see it. Remember that I ran Notepad already. That's what we're going to run here. I'm going to enter the following. D-I-R space slash capital O colon minus capital D. Now, I realize that is so much voodoo, so much magic. This is an old style directory listing command from the Windows command prompt that essentially says, show me the directory, show me all the files in the current directory. Slash O means order them by, colon is a separator. D means the date of the file, and the minus sign means show them in reverse order. So what I'm going to do is file, save as, we're going to notice what folder we're in. This says this PC documents, which if we click in it, you can see it says the documents folder. In reality, I'll show you where that is on the disk in a moment. What I'm going to save it as is tdir.cmd. In other words, the TDIR is just me making up a name, and rather than the dir command, I used TDIR because it's a time-based DIR command. .cmd is the file extension that tells Windows this is a batch file. .bat is also acceptable. It's a very minor difference that honestly, you'll never run into unless you're working with some really old compatibility issues. .cmd is preferred these days for Windows command prompt. So having saved it then as tdir.cmd, I'm going to run a Windows command prompt. I'm going to do that this time by right-clicking here. In my case, I happen to have Windows Terminal. I'm going to use admin because one of the examples coming up is going to require admin privileges. So what I have here is Windows PowerShell. That is not what I want. That is not what we are doing. What I want instead is to open a new tab as command prompt. That's what we're doing. Windows PowerShell, as nifty as it is, runs a different language. You can run .cmd files in it, but I want to keep things clear. .cmd files and .bat files are intended for the Windows command prompt, cmd.exe if you happen to run it directly, but it's not PowerShell. So now we are in this users askle folder, that's users and then my login name for this machine. The documents folder is here, but of course this one is empty, and that's because I'm using OneDrive to back up this folder, which means the documents folder we care about is in OneDrive slash documents. And there you'll find tdir.cmd. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to change directories to make that the current folder. Now to run tdir, all I really need to do is type tdir and hit enter. Because it's in the current folder, it looks there first to see if there's a command called tdir. If there is, that's what gets run. So what we've done now is we've just run this batch file we've created. What it did is it ran the dir command with these parameters, and the result, of course, is a listing of the files in that folder in reverse chronological order. So that's all well and good, but why would we ever want to do this? Well, like I said, this is an oversimplified example of some of the things you can start to do with it. What I'm going to do now is actually give you something I consider to be relatively useful. I'm going to go back to Notepad. I'm going to create a new file. And into this file, I've typed very quickly through the magic of copy paste the following three commands: net stop spooler, a delete command with a fairly long parameter of what to delete, and then net start spooler. If you have had printer queue problems, you've probably seen the article, "My printer queue is stuck. How do I print anything?" This sequence of three commands clears the print queue. This does require that you be running an administrative command prompt, and that's fine. That's why I ran the administrative command prompt earlier. But the point is that rather than having to type each of these three commands in separately every time you need to clear your print queue, all you need to do is save this, and I'm going to give it a different name, save as clearprint. And again, .cmd. That's important. If you just were to save clear print without doing the .cmd, it would actually save it as a .txt file, and that is not a batch file. Windows will not recognize that as a batch file. It's important to include the extension .cmd. So now I have clear print on .cmd. If I go over to the documents folder where these things were getting saved and I just do a regular dir, there you'll see clear print .cmd. If I now run clearprint.cmd, it will clear the print queue. It's stopping the spooler, it's deleting the files, and it's starting the spooler again. That's a lot easier than typing those three commands in individually every time you need them. And as you can see, clearprint is probably something that's a lot easier to type and a lot easier to remember than that complicated delete command there in the middle where we're deleting something buried in the Windows directory structure. So that's one example of another really useful way that batch files can help. They can combine multiple commands that are executed in sequence. So there's another example in the companion article with this video that shows you how batch files can take parameters. For advanced batch file usage, that can be kind of handy. I'm not going to demonstrate it here. I'll point you at that article for it. It's askleo.com/3688. But the point there is that batch files have a number of constructs that make them pretty close to full-on programming languages. If you've ever heard the term scripting language, that's what we're doing here. Batch files are more correctly referred to as scripts. Do this, then do this, then do this. That's all they really boil down to. They have all sorts of constructs. You can loop, you can exit, you can test, you can do a number of different things. But the point is, for very basic usage, like this print queue clear that we just did, it can be a really simple and useful thing to save you a lot of time and avoid a lot of errors in the future. So the question often comes up, great, what can I do in a batch file? I mean, you've showed me a few things, I don't know where they came from. The bottom line is that anything that you can run using the Windows R key in this run dialog box can be run from within a batch file. What does that mean? How do you make that happen? Well, there are two concepts at play here. One is that Windows has this concept of what's called a path. Whenever you type something into either the run dialog or the Windows command prompt, it searches along this path, this list of folders, for something that matches what you just typed in. If it finds it, in the first place it finds it, that's what it's going to run. So what that means is that you can put your batch file in one of these locations. C:\Windows is one example of such a place. C:\Windows/System32 is where all of Windows' built-in utilities come from. You get the idea. It's a long list. If I type path, you can see the list of folders that Windows will look at in turn. As soon as I type something like net start spooler, what Windows is doing is it's walking that list of folders, Windows System 32, Windows System 32 WBEM, and so on, looking for net.exe, net.bat, net.command, net.a number of other file extensions. As soon as it finds one, in this case, it finds net.exe somewhere in that path, it runs it. and it's ready to go. So if you were to put your own batch files in, say, System 32 or just Windows, they will get found automatically without you having to specify the full path to the batch file. But that's the other thing that can happen, is that you can specify the full path to whatever it is you want to run. I'm going to do that. You can see that I'm here in Users, askleo, OneDrive, Documents. What I'm going to do is I'm going to use file completion or file name completion to make this happen. So I'll clear the screen here so we can see what I'm going to do. I will type program files, and I'm just using the tab key to automatically fill out the rest. Program files, Microsoft, Office, root, as it turns out. Let's see, there's a number of different things here. Office 16, I think, was what I want. And there I can go with winword.exe. So you can see I have typed the full path to a program that is not on the path. It's not going to be found automatically. In fact, if I were to just type winword, nothing would happen. But if I were to double click on the winword icon or the word icon in my start menu, well, that's already hard coded this exact path. What that means is that if I just hit enter on this full path, it's now going to run Word. Anything that you can do that to, anything on your machine that you can just enter and have it run, you can use in a batch file. Now, to be clear, I've really just scratched the surface. There is so much more that you can do with batch files. And as I mentioned earlier, if you really want to get into this kind of scripting, PowerShell brings a whole nother level, it's a different language, but a whole nother level of both power and complexity to your ability to script things using a text file or command file type structure. If that's interesting to you, great. That's where you want to start looking. But in the meantime, if you just want to make that print queue easier to clear, well, now you know how to throw three or more commands into a batch file and have it be something simple. Hope that was helpful. For updates, for comments, for related links and more, visit askleo.com/3688. I'm Leo Notenboom, and this is askleo.com. Thanks for watching.